Welcome to Virtual Worship with the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring. I am Carolyn Savadkin, today's worship associate, and my pronouns are she, her, hers. Our theme for the month of November is healing, and in the midst of plague and profound national division, it is a timely topic for us to reflect on together as a community. This morning, we will catch our breath after an intense week and remember that no matter how any election unfolds, love calls us on to the work of healing ourselves and the world around us. I'm glad all of you are here in virtual community while we can't be together in person. Whether you are joining us live or watching this service after the live broadcast, I'm so glad you are here. I'd also like to welcome everyone who is joining us for the first or second time. Jim Street is our welcoming captain and will be glad to answer your questions in the chat. Jim will also be available during virtual coffee hour after the service. In an effort to make the service more accessible to everyone, the worship committee has decided to try an experiment. During today's service, the chat will be turned off during the time for all ages, and then again during the reading and sermon. The chat will be enabled so that we can all share our joys and sorrows, and toward the beginning and end of the service as usual. If you are watching live, you can log in Google to participate in the chat in real time during certain portions of today's service. Comments will not be available for later playback. But during the parts of the service when the chat is enabled, they are very public, so please keep that in mind. American Sign Language interpretation is available in the separate Zoom room for those who are deaf or hard of hearing. If you need to find that link, please ask in the chat or email thetechsupport@uucss.org to get the slide. In a few moments, everyone will be invited to light our flaming chalices. So now is a good time to go and get a chalice, a candle, or even a flashlight so you can join in the kindling of the flame of community. But first, let's take a moment to say thank you to all those who have made today's service possible. Now, please join me in the words on your screen as we light our chalices and reaffirm our congregational commitment. May this light warm our heart with love and caring and guide us in the ways of truth. As we gather here for worship, we pledge ourselves to the endless search for truth, to the right of each to believe as mind, heart, and conscience dictate, to accept the responsibility this freedom commands, and to implement our belief in the essential worth and dignity of every human being. May it be so. Now let's join together in singing. The words to the song of exaltation will appear on your screen.
May that which brings order out of chaos, clarity out of confusion, purpose out of uncertainty be in us and with us as we gather in prayer, song, and community. Come, Spirit of love, and guide our hearts, our minds, our whole selves towards all that nurtures and sustains, heals, and reconciles. With this power, in this spirit, let us worship together. Now, let's join in singing.
Gonna keep on moving forward. Keep on moving forward. Keep on moving forward. Never turning back, never turning back. Gonna keep on moving forward, keep on moving forward, keep on moving forward, never turning. Gonna keep on moving forward. keep on moving forward. Keep on moving forward. Never turning back. Never turning back. When you keep on moving proudly.
To vote, say I love you every day with your mouth, by Alice Walker. You must say aloud, I love you, at least 5 times every day. You will feel it immediately in your heart and know you are doing it right. Say it to a tree, and say it to a frog. Say it to the sky, which at last you understand is not a solid thing, like a bowl. Say it to water as you drink it, or after, so you don't choke. Say it to the fire, always exquisite in itself, if sometimes unruly. Say it to the birds, the octopus, the raccoons, and by all means, the gopher snake. Say it to the skunks. How can they be so cute and smell so bad? Say it to the dirt under your feet. Say it with extra emotion to rocks. Imagine what they know and have been through. Say it to plums and rivers and bees. Say it to the artists, both above and below, and to ancestors alive in you or dead. Say it to the hopefully stubborn. Say it to the sun, who has seen it all and is never surprised. Say it to the moon, who keeps tabs on us monthly, if you know what I mean. But say it aloud. Feel it in your heart. I promise you there will be a light that warms every part of you, but especially the part you rarely feel, your soul. You will move through this present sorrow comforted by your own internal weather, whatever chilly climate you encounter, and however frozen are the hearts in the land in which you dwell.
I love you too, and all four of your horses and pandas. See, I am saying it aloud now. We are practicing together. I feel it in my heart. And that is not by any means the end of our ability to love this planet, not nearly the end of the reach of our global landslide. Stock photos provided by Pixabay.
Now is the time in our worship when we share our joys and sorrows. This is a holy time. It's a time of deep sharing and deep listening. If you have a great joy, I hope that you'll share it with us this morning because this community wants to rejoice with you. And if you are here with us carrying a great sorrow or worry on your heart, I hope that you will share that too because this community is here to help you bear it. During the music, if you're worshiping with us live, I invite you to type your joys or sorrows into the chat box, remembering that everything shared in the chat box is public during the live broadcast. If you could use support beyond what is offered here and now, please email layministers@uucss.org and let them know you'd like to have a conversation. If you're watching this as a recording later, please take this time to hold in loving compassion all those in your life and in our world who are in need, and to give thanks for your blessings. Let us now open our hearts to the joys and sorrows this gathered community has to share. Spirit of life, this morning we rejoice with all who shared their joys with us, and we hold tenderly in love and compassion all those who shared sorrows and concerns. This day and all days, may we find strength in sharing and bearing our burdens with one another, and may we find comfort knowing that as part of this community, we need not bear any burden or sorrow alone. When the clamor of the world's injustice threatens to sink us into despair, may we remember that ours is also a world of goodness and beauty. And when the world's chaos overwhelms us, bring us back to this time and this space shared together, and that in each moment this same peace is available to us. And when we fall short of our highest ideals, in those times when we are not our best selves, help us to forgive ourselves and ask forgiveness of others. For we are called to be honest and faithful to the values of this free faith, but we are not called to be perfect. And that there is nothing we can do or fail to do that will ever make us unworthy of love. For the comfort of being together in this time and this space on this crisp autumn morning, for the gift of one another, friends and companions along life's journey, for the familiar rituals of flame and song and story, for the space to reconnect with the still small voice deep within, no matter what is happening all around us, we give thanks. For these and for all of the yearnings and prayers of our innermost hearts, we pray in the name of all that is most noble and holy. Amen.
When I breathe in, I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love. When I breathe in, I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love. When I breathe in, I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love.
I invite you now into a time of meditation. Perhaps sitting comfortably with your arms by your sides and your feet flat on the floor. I invite you into a time of becoming aware of your body, your mind, of all that is happening within you and around you in this moment, here and now. I invite you to close your eyes, to notice the breath of life filling your lungs each time you breathe in and leaving them each time you breathe out. I invite you now into a time of guided meditation. Breathing in, I am aware of my pain. Breathing out, I am aware that I am not my pain. Breathing in, I am aware of my past. Breathing out, I am aware that I am not my past. Breathing in, I am aware of my anger. Breathing out, I am aware that I am not my anger. Breathing in, I am aware of my despair. Breathing out, I am aware that I am not my despair. Breathing in, I am aware of peace. Breathing out, I am aware that I am worthy of peace. Breathing in, I am aware of love. Breathing out, I am aware that I am worthy of love. Breathing in, I am aware of joy. Breathing out, I am aware that I am an agent of joy. Breathing in, I am aware of hope. Breathing out, I am aware that I am an agent of hope. Breathing in, I am aware. Last month, an Associated Press poll found that 85% of registered voters described Americans as greatly divided in their values, and only 15% felt that democracy in the U.S. is working. Now, I long ago stopped paying much attention to the polls, but that one sure reflects just how difficult and divisive this time in our lives and in the lives of this nation really is. For the last 4 years, we've seen senior government officials degrade people of color, women, entire cities like Chicago and Baltimore, and attack the free press. The Foreign Service has all but been dismantled, protections for the environment dashed, and this country's global security weakened. And instead of being a uniting force, the COVID-19 virus has been used as yet another wedge to divide the American people. Every single issue, every event and non-event, every real or imagined difference between and among us has been used as a way to try and divide us into ever smaller groups. It's against this harrowing backdrop that we've watched the election results trickle in this week, unsure what numbers to trust, unsure of the impact of voter intimidation and suppression on the eventual outcome, unsure if the outcome of the Electoral College will affirm the will of the people. As you know, the services here at the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring are pre-recorded. And as of today's recording, the results of the election are still unclear. I suppose it's possible we will know more by the time the service is broadcast, but from what I understand, a lot can happen between now and the Electoral College vote. Rather than the decisive answer we were all hoping for, it seems Election Day has cracked open yet another level of uncertainty in our government and our lives. And most of us are really tired. Tired of not being able to gather together in the flesh and hug each other when we're concerned about our democracy, our community, our future. Tired of skimming the news in a constant state of dread, wondering how our government will endanger or embarrass us next. Tired of this system that we know is broken, just getting worse and worse, serving the whims of a few rich and powerful people rather than the life and death needs of the many. And it's tempting right now to just tune it all out, just pull the covers up over our heads and lick our wounds. And maybe some of us need to do those things for a while. The losses and trauma we've experienced in this pandemic alone are reason enough to take time off to rest and recharge, if you can. Some of us may need to curl up by the fire and lose ourselves in a novel, get all of that winter prep yard work done that we've been putting off, or watch every single episode in a row of The Great British Baking Show. It's also true that some of us don't have the luxury to relax right now. Some of us don't have access to all that we need, let alone creature comforts we might want. Some among us feel like we don't have the bandwidth to do for freedom and justice as much as we might feel we should. Some among us must keep on keeping on anyway, making a way out of no way, trying our best to stay kind, parenting while working, while supervising virtual school, without enough time or space to feel like we are doing any of it particularly well. Wherever you are in your life, in your circumstance, wherever you are emotionally right now, I hope the truth I'm about to share feels like good news. Because the truth in the midst of the mess right now is that our work for justice and freedom is the work of a lifetime. It's a marathon, it's not a sprint. There are going to be times when we are in exactly the right place and time to offer a whole lot of ourselves. Sometimes we will be the people who are in the position to take the risks, to flood the streets, to apply direct pressure right where it needs to go. And there will be other times when the best thing that we can do for the movement is to care for ourselves and to raise up our children and to make it through the day ahead of us. There will be times when we carry the baton, times when we must pass it to another person so we can rest, and times when we need to serve those running some water. I know it's felt as if Election Day took forever to get here, and now that it's come and gone, the resolution we hoped it would bring may still be far off in the distance. Dominant culture in this country teaches us to value resolution, to move from one bullet point to the next, onward and upward toward greater and greater success and wealth and progress forever. But that's just not the way reality seems to work. And I think this is part of what's so spiritually challenging in these times. Buddhist teacher Pema Chodron puts it well when she says, "We think that the point is to pass the test or overcome the problem, but the truth is that things don't really get solved. They come together and they fall apart. Then they come together again and fall apart again. It's just like that. The healing comes from letting there be room for all of this to happen. Room for grief, room for relief, room for misery, room for joy." As the late Congressman John Lewis has written, and as we heard last week in our service, storms come and go and then come back again. But it is the people clasping hands who won't leave the house who keep it from blowing down all around us. Now, the storm we are in is a bad one. A whole lot of important things have fallen apart. So much has been lost. So many people have died. And somehow, even though we may not be able to chart how, I believe we will get from here to there. I believe things will come together once again. And along the way, through the busyness and the overwhelm and the loneliness of these uncertain days, the healing will come from letting there be room for it all. Room for the grief and the relief, room for the misery and the joy, room for the faith and the disbelief, room for the despair and the hope. E.B. White once famously wrote, "I arise in the morning torn between the desire to improve the world and a desire to enjoy the world. This makes it hard to plan the day." If we are to heal ourselves and be part of the healing of this country, we must, to the best of our ability, make time and space for both saving and savoring this world of ours. Because these are painful times, but we are not our pain. Because we have been disappointed in some pretty huge ways, but we are not our disappointment. Because the injustice all around us raises anger in so many of our hearts, but we are not our anger. Because the immensity of the tasks ahead can make us feel despair, but we are not our despair. Because alongside the reality of our pain and disappointment, there is also joy and hope. Joy that comes in the morning after even the hardest nights. Hope that has guided generations of justice makers before us, many of whom faced much bleaker odds than we do now. Alongside the reality of our anger and despair, there is also peace and there is great love. Peace among us here and now. Peace among the millions who worked hard this week to promote a free and fair election. And love. Love that is patient and kind. Love that binds us one to another. Love that is willing to risk a whole lot so others can have what they need. Love that is bigger and wider and stronger than any wedge someone might try to use to separate us one from another. In the days ahead, may we know the healing that comes from making room for it all. Room for grief and relief, room for misery and joy. May we know ourselves to be agents of joy and hope, peace and love. Because while trouble may lurk at every turn, it is love that calls us on. Amen.
Thank you.
I now invite each and every person tuning into this service, whether live or at a later time, to make a financial offering to this congregation. Your offering today will help fuel the flame of this community and make our ministries and programs possible. But most importantly, making an offering will allow you to practice generosity to contribute to this community that can do more good together than any of us can do alone. There are three ways you can make your financial gift to the congregation. The first is by downloading the Give Plus mobile app from Vanco to set up an account. The second way to give is by using your phone to text a message to 833-880-1363. And if the app or texting just don't work for you, the third way is by mailing a check directly to the church. All the information you need for all these three methods is on your screen now and will appear again toward the end of today's service. Every program, our different ministries, and all of the support and music and fellowship of this congregation is possible not because we charge people to participate, not because we attach a fee to all the work we do. It is all possible through our shared generosity. I hope you will join me in making an offering in thanks for all that UUCSS means to you. The offering will now be given and received with gratitude.
And the Spirit's gracious power.
May the gifts we have given fuel the flame of our commitment, empower us to serve out our mission, and give the life we share the shape of truth, love, and justice.
Good morning. Thank you for being here today. I am Carl Miller, and I am the board president at the Unitarian Universalist Church of Silver Spring. My pronouns are he, him, and his. Our church is not only the organization that puts together these services. We are a vibrant community of volunteers and staff, a member of the Unitarian Universalist Association, and a part of the global UU denomination. Visitors are especially welcome to our virtual coffee hour after the service to learn more about us. Today I have one announcement about an upcoming event. In these uncertain days, many are seeking wisdom and inspiration to help guide our living. Those who are not participating in the Jubilee training next weekend are invited to join Reverend Kristin next Sunday, November 15th at 1:00 p.m. for a new adult religious education class called Reading, Resilience, and Resistance. In each class, we will engage deeply with one another and with words written by people who persisted and found joy in times of tumult and oppression. Classes will be held on third Tuesdays at 7:30 p.m. and third Sundays at 1:00 p.m., but you don't need to commit to every class to participate. Please contact Reverend Kristin if you have questions, and keep an eye out in your all-church emails for the links to each class. We give thanks for all the activities that enrich and enliven our congregational life.
To come.
Please join me in the words to extinguish the chalice. Carry the flame of peace and love until we meet again.
Come what may, love calls us on. Our worship has ended, and now our service begins.
When heaven seems so far away, and dreams are just a memory, without the dark, the light won't show. Remember that you're not alone. When you watch the world just turn away, and break the promises it made, when love is all too hard to hold. So far away, and dreams are just a memory, when love is all too hard to hold, just take a breath and let it go.